Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be talking about how to calculate car loan payments in Google Sheets. This is going to be done through the use of the PMT function, which calculates the payment of a loan based on constant payments and a constant interest rate. As most car loans are relatively short, they are usually fixed interest rates. We'll talk more about these parameters that we need shortly, so do not worry too much about them right now. Let's begin by creating a small table that will become our car loan calculator. We need the purchase price of the vehicle. Then we need how much money we want to put down upon purchasing the vehicle. I'll also add a row that's going to be an option if you want to add in a trade-in value if you're selling your current vehicle to the dealership. A subtotal for the amount of the loan that will be financed, meaning the purchase price of the vehicle minus our down payment and minus our trade-in. This will be the amount of loan that we are essentially borrowing from the dealer in exchange for interest rate on that loan. Lastly, we need to know the interest rate of the loan. That is going to be taken from our lender. The lender here can either be a bank or the car dealership itself. And the number of years over which we plan to repay the loan. Let's begin by calculating our monthly payment on this loan. I'm just going to throw in a few values here now. We now need to call our payment function, which we do by selecting this cell and typing equals PMT open parentheses. At this point, Sheets will tell us which arguments need to be filled. Just as a quick side note, if you ever do not know what a Sheets function does or what arguments it's asking you for, you can simply click this drop-down arrow here and a help window will open explaining the function and all of its arguments. As you can see, our first argument is the rate, which is our interest rate per payment period. This is not our 4.49% listed above, as that is our yearly interest rate, also sometimes known as APR or annual percentage rate. This is what you will commonly see the lenders advertise. As we are trying to find our monthly car payment, our interest applied to each repayment will be 1/12 of our APR, as there are 12 months in a year. Therefore, for this argument, we'll enter our APR over 12. Next up, we have our number of period payments to be made over the length of the loan. So, if we are looking to make monthly payments, then our number of repayment periods would simply be 5 years times 12 months, meaning we will make a total of 60 payments. The last required parameter that we need to give our payment function is the present value or the amount of our loan. This is our calculated amount from earlier that we said was our total amount we needed to finance. So let's just click that cell. Finishing out our parentheses and hitting enter, we'll get the monthly amount of our loan is $400 a month. But how much interest rate are we actually losing by financing this car? Well, fortunately, this is very easy for us to find. To calculate the cost of this loan, all we need to do is multiply our monthly payments by the number of months that we are paying the loan. So this is going to be 5 years times 12 months times our monthly payment. Therefore, the total loan cost will be $24,043.63. The amount of interest paid will be this total loan cost minus the amount we financed. This works out to about $2,500 lost to interest rate. At this point, we are finished with the basic car loan calculator, and we can play with some of our variables if we want. For example, let's say that we get a better interest rate of 2.49%. This results in a small reduction in our monthly payment, but as you can see, our interest loss to our lender is almost cut in half. If you wish to calculate our biweekly payments instead of monthly payments, all you need to do is repeat our PMT function using 26 instead of 12, as there are 52 weeks in a year and we are paying every 2 weeks. 52 divided by 2 is 26. Obviously, you could automate this calculator through Sheets' many features, such as adding drop-down menus for payment frequencies or calculating whether it is better to invest your spare money in the stock market or to pay off your car loan quicker. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to make a basic car loan calculator in Google Sheets. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.